Americans and Europeans are used to having low-budget airlines to travel within the continent and domestically, and soon travelers in Africa will too. Airlines like Kululu in South Africa, FastJet, Fly Africa, and JamboJet in Kenya are taking off in the African market. Helping map out these new options for getting around in Africa is Tony Carroll. He's Vice President of Manchester Trade. Tony, welcome back to Arise Xchange. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. Thanks.
So we've had low-cost carriers in the United States for some time, and then, of course, in Europe, you have airlines like Ryanair. Is this a rather new trend in Africa?
Well, it's emerging in the last decade. It's starting to pick up strength outside of South Africa, which has really always been at the core of this development.
And basically, what's driving it? Are Africans traveling more by air than they have in the past? And are they traveling outside of their countries?
Well, it's evidence of an emergent middle class, which we've spoken about before on this program. It's also deregulation, actualization of the Open Skies Treaties, and increasing travel outside of countries, regional travel, some international travel is certainly picking up.
And they're certainly using the European and American models, right, because they're no-frills carriers, but they're also marketing them sort of to be kind of fun and hip, if you will.
Yeah, I mean, they green and orange colors, they tell jokes when you fly, they throw peanuts at you, just like they do in the United States.
And the African carriers, for the most part, are they operating at the standards that we would expect in Europe and the U.S.?
I think African standards are pretty high. I don't get it. There have been certainly some exceptions. Dana Air in Nigeria had a crash a few years ago, but they operate at a high standard. The aircrafts are well-serviced and for the most part, equivalent, at least in age, as our budget airlines have.
You know, I'm looking at your notes here, and what is interesting is that a substantial percentage of customers to these low-cost carriers are, in fact, first-time travelers, first-time air travelers.
Incredibly, EasyJet, 36% of the travelers are first-time travelers.
And where are they going in Africa? Are they visiting neighboring countries? Are they exploring the continent more? And are these business travelers or tourism travelers?
Well, I think that's hard to decipher whether they're business or tourism. I think it's a combination of both. Certainly South Africa, a large country, you're seeing a lot more frequency of travel within the country. But along East Africa and Southern Africa, you're starting to see a lot more international travel and regional travel. These airlines are branching out. Hub and Spoke, Nairobi, Johannesburg tend to be the two big centers, and they're now starting to expand. West Africa is still slow to come to the fore in this area of budget air travel.
And why is that? Why is West Africa lagging behind?
Well, I think one of the issues is the in regulatory environment. There's less cohesion in West Africa. You got some English-speaking countries, some French-speaking countries. It hasn't operated in the same sort of unified platforms that you found more frequently in East and Southern Africa. But there's a lot of traffic, and Eric Air, which has done very well as a new private carrier in West Africa, is starting to pick up the trend and is about to launch from what's been reported at their own budget airline.
You talk about regulatory environment. In Europe, you have something called Open Skies. Are we seeing that in Africa?
Well, there's actually been an Open Skies treaty for almost 20 years called the Yamoussoukro Agreement. It's just been very slow to be actualized, and partly because many of the national carriers were government-owned, and they were, shall we say, leery about introducing competition. That battle's been lost long ago, and they're starting to open up and see the benefits of liberalization and travel.
You know, we talk a lot about infrastructure when we talk about Africa. Airplanes need places to land. So the question is Africa building more airports, and are they building airports in areas that are harder to reach, for example?
Well, of course, a lot of it will be determined on volume, and it's a sort of chicken and egg situation. Build a better airfield, there'll be more frequent travel. I think it's coming slowly. I think that's one of the real constraints on the development of air travel in Africa is the development of airfields and attendant facilities, particularly in secondary markets. You know, cities like Kumasi, Yamoussoukro, which we mentioned before, Mombasa, well, that's a fairly sizable airfield. But still, some of these secondary cities are, shall we say, lagging in infrastructure standards.
And quickly, we have about 30 seconds. President Obama is going to travel to Kenya soon. When the president travels to Africa, does that help tourism?
Of course. It puts Africa on the map. He welcomes his heritage. It's going to be a great moment for Africa. Now that we have AGOA passed, he'll bring something in hand. We can talk about that next time.
We will indeed. Tony Carroll, thank you from Washington, D.C. Appreciate it.
Pleasure is mine.